Logan on
ex-porn star, and she's just a girl. Just a girl. She's just a person, just like everybody else.
And you know, I see you on a pulse of, and you're constantly saying like, "Hey, our audience is older.
100%. Stand by it.
Now we got college kids watching us, and it's not the little kid."
Yeah.
And then like the very next day after you said that, like a bunch of like 12-year-olds ran up to you in the street, and
six-year-olds.
Yeah,
6-year-olds, not even 12-year-olds. But let me ask you a question, Keem. Are we talking about outliers here? Are we talking about data?
I'm just saying, like, we all have the data, right? And I'm sure that our data.
Where were you guys when this?
Actually,
group
I don't think our data is probably
were.
Similar, but I bet mine's a little bit.
We were in Times Square. I know exactly what he's talking about. I would say that the demographic that currently watches Logan Paul's vlogs and more so Impulsive is much older than the demographic that watches Drama.
Well, what's
drama
the average
alert.
Age? What's the average
I would say
age?
Probably, I would assume it's probably between 17 and 20
I mean,
years
I could
old.
I could publicly put out my tweets.
I can't dispute it because obviously I don't have the figures,
I have my figures, and most of my viewers are adults. I mean, of course, kids lie about their age when they make a YouTube channel, but that's
we could obviously pull it up. And on Impulsive, which is the platform in question, which is the one you brought up, I would assume it's even older. I would assume the Impulsive base is 22 to 26.
Listen, I don't like when people give the responsibility to any creator as far as who is attracted to their content in the first place. Like, if a group of 6-year-olds runs up to you,
well,
that's not your fucking fault.
But we got to go a case by case basis because there are some YouTubers that do directly try and convey their videos to kids.
I'm a firm believer in make the fucking content you want.
Logan Paul and Jake Paul definitely went out of their way to target a younger audience.
Yeah, five years ago.
So you don't think there's still going to be a huge, huge proportion of kids watching the content? I suppose they have aged by 5 years.
Anyone's welcome to a transition
sure,
and to change
what
they do.
That's not what we're saying.
100%. 100%.
Yes, of course. We're not saying that, though. We're just saying that, like, you know, you... those audiences and that fame was built on targeting a younger demographic of children. I mean, like Jake, for example, which is not Logan. I know they're two different people, but Jake, for example, literally made a music video where he was dressed up as Santa, telling his fucking fans to bag their parents for Jake Paul merch.
Yeah,
like,
I mean,
like,
I mean, Keem, listen,
no.
You're not invincible from pushing adult content to kids, dude. Like, let's be honest. I mean, you play.
Oh, I've always been adult. Like, I've never had like little kid content. I've never like dressed up like Santa and said, "Hey guys, sit on my knee."
Well, hold on. Let's talk. No, you never dressed up. You never dressed up as Santa, but you never dressed up as Santa, but you talk about influencers that are watched by children.
Oh,
you talk about Austin McBroom. You talk about so who do you think gives a fuck about Austin McBroom
if it was six and eight year olds, Mike, my videos would get spammed with dislikes.
Keem, they don't.
Surely it's both.
My videos would be spammed with dislikes. Those fans
Let me finish my point.
Those little kids are drones, all right? They can't think for themselves. When we were younger, we were the same way, right? We didn't think for ourselves, like little followers, right? We didn't develop into our own person, right? Your followers when you're younger. And so if the content that I'm making is attracting all the Jake Paulers and all the Logan Paulers or whatever, my videos would be spammed with dislikes because they're not going to put up with me, you know, shitting on the Pauls.
Surely it's both, right? It's going to attract some kid fans who are fans of that particular person you're talking about.
Can we all just be honest with ourselves for a second?
And adults who just can't stand the
fucking
guy.
Hold on, hold on.
Well, you can't say hold on when you're interrupting me, Mike. Come on, I know you're the guest.
It's me. That was me.
Sorry, thanks. Thanks. Sorry,
you do sound similar. I've been trying to make this point for fucking 5 minutes. We're all tripping if any one of us is going to... None of us give a fuck who's watching our videos. Most YouTubers don't give a fuck who's watching their videos.
No, I'm sorry. I do give a fuck because I've got some... I'm saying some things in my videos that I wouldn't want...
That's not
kids
my
watching.
Responsibility, though. That's my stance. I don't know if it's wrong. That's not my fucking
it's
responsibility.
Parents' responsibility.
We're not talking about responsibility. We're talking about whether we care or not. Completely different thing.
You're an anomaly then.
That's not an anomaly. I think a lot of people feel the same way.
I think most YouTubers are just looking to give the right answer if they try to. Whether it's Logan Paul, whether it's Keem, I agree. I think
at the end of the day, this is my take on it. Logan, Jake, Dobrik, Austin. It's always been easy to hate these guys because they're on fucking top. Keem looks at Logan having a $35 million year.
I don't think anybody hates
him. Yes, they do. Keem, hold on a second. Keem, let's get to agreement on this. Keemstar has gone out of his way day after day for the past years of his life to break down the Paul family. He would do anything. He would tweet insufferable, ridiculous, factless bullshit to come at the Paul family in any way, shape, or form possible. I think that Keemstar has more of a hard-on for Jake and Logan Paul than any other person I've ever seen on this planet. And if you disagree with that, you're lying to yourself. Unfortunately, I don't know anything about this clown guy. I don't know what he creates, what he produces.
Guy.
I've never seen anything or seen
his name. I'm not trying to disrespect.
Yeah. I'm not trying to disrespect you. I just don't know what your take is.
All right. I will tell you my take.
Look, I let me respond. Can I respond to that, please? Look.
And that's what he does. He criticizes.
Keem hates the Pauls.
But that's a fact.
Let me respond to that. I've been a YouTuber for 11 years, okay? I've seen these guys come over on Vine, and I've seen them, you know, Jake Paul make a cringy music video. I was the first to talk about it and say, oh, my God, what is this, right? And then I saw Jake Paul jumping up on a TV van, and then I reported that. And then we saw the mass, like, manipulation and extortion from these little kids over and over again. I mean, the videos were just commercials. Buy this merch. So what you do is you naturally, like, you respect people like Logan and Jake Paul as entertainers when they were in 2017, when they were, you know, doing their show. But you also have to, like, kind of hate what they're doing, right? It was becoming less and less about the content and more and more about selling the t-shirts.
I get it.
Let me explain Keemstar's. Sorry, go on, Mike. You're the guest.
If they were targeting teenagers, fine, but they were targeting, like, little kids.